Hey there, Cosmic Warriors, and welcome back to another video. Okay, so in today's video, we are going to be taking a look at the beauty, relationships, envy, and seduction of those of you who have Venus in the third house within your natal birth chart. So stay tuned. However, before we do dive into today's video, certainly make sure that you give this video a like if you do like it. Also, make sure to subscribe if you have not already, and to, of course, click that little bell icon so that you can keep yourself updated with further content from myself. And one more quick thing to mention, and that is that I have some personal birth chart readings available there, along with merchandise pieces, as well as practical ebooks. So if you are interested in any of these things, then please go to the links in the description box below. You can visit my website. Okay, so with all of those introductions out of the way, Venus in the third house, let's do this. Okay, so first and foremost, when it comes to Venus, make sure that you're looking at your Libra house along with your Taurus house, because both of these signs are ruled by Venus within astrology, and so they can give you more information. But if you do have Venus in the third house, then what this suggests is that you are someone who loves communicating and socializing with others, so much so that you might strive to earn a living through the art of communication. So you might take on new subjects as a way to help you improve upon your communication skills, for example. Or you might reach out to others as a way to build upon new relationships, which can in turn help you enhance your knowledge and your intellect. Or you might look into positions that involve the likes of writing, broadcasting, marketing, sales, public speaking, commentating, and really just any area that requires you to use your voice as well as your mind specifically. Though essentially there's a genuine love for connecting with people and getting into the minds of other people and conversing with other people and wanting to learn more about people. You might actually be fascinated by how people think and how they speak and how they exchange and share information. And you also possess such a curiosity towards the likes of singing, music, art, fashion, beauty. Maybe you actually write music, or you play an instrument, or maybe you read up on fashion slash beauty trends, or perhaps you enjoy making videos and making posts online, so looking at social media, or quite possibly you love singing and humming to yourself. Maybe you have the mind of a naturally gifted singer even. And if not singing, then perhaps you are naturally gifted at writing or researching or speaking. Oh, and when you speak, you may come across as smooth, sweet, and gracious. You seem to charm others with your words ever so eloquently, and so others like you, they gravitate towards you. Perhaps you know exactly what to say in order to get others on your side, and you know which tone to use and how to say certain things. Even if your approach can be a little bit manipulative at times, because you are actually seeking to make things more peaceful and more harmonious for yourself. Oh yeah. You sure know how to ease your way in and out of any conversation. And you may do this so pleasantly, it seems effortless and with good taste. And when you are conversing with others, you might have the tendency of complimenting whoever it is that you're speaking with. And maybe you will compliment them in the middle of a discussion and they will just love it. They will soak this up, these other people. Though, with that being said, perhaps your compliments, they are used as a way to deflect any negative feedback that you receive from others. So instead of taking responsibility for something you said, maybe you avoid it by making it seem as if you are sweet and you're kind. That way you're no longer in the hot seat. Indeed, it's you, Venus, in the third house individuals who know how to charm the socks off others. You may know how to wrap others around your little finger. And so people usually don't stay mad at you for too long when you do upset them. Now, with that being said, also make sure that you consider the sign that Venus is in along with aspects respectfully, because maybe there's some of you who actually don't come across as all that charming and gracious. Or maybe there's those of you who are more quiet, you're more reserved. Or perhaps even there's those of you who feel deeply insecure about how you communicate and how you socialize. And so you don't feel comfortable in certain social settings, but there's still a desire to glow when it comes to connecting with others. There's a desire to cooperate and to join together with others through the art of communication. And there's a type of harmony that you wish to achieve. Naturally, however, this harmony may not be obtained from time to time, especially when disagreements arise. But when such things happen, I think you're someone who seeks to restore peace once again. And when you notice others disagreeing and potentially arguing with each other, I think you try your best to remain impartial so you don't make it seem as if you're taking sides, because then that can translate into somebody else possibly being upset with you. And also because you try your very best to gather up all of the information from all parties or from both parties involved. Everybody has their side and everybody has their point of view, which I think you are pretty open to. And when it comes to getting others to see your point of view, well, you may be quite gifted in this respect, especially given that you help others see how your view can benefit them. And this right here can make you great at compromising and negotiating, Venus in the third house individuals. Now again, make sure that you are looking at the sign along with aspects, because it could very well be that some of you have zero negotiation skills, which actually bugs you, or maybe some of you have to really make a conscious effort when it comes to getting others on your side academically and intellectually. Now, with that being said, perhaps there are those of you who just have a lovely communicative style. You choose your words brilliantly. You create a pleasant and loving atmosphere wherever you go due to your wording or your voice or your tone. And you share your ideas in such a flattering and beautiful way. You make it seem effortless. In fact, you might be excellent at seducing others with your words or with your voice. Perhaps you possess a rather seductive and flirtatious voice / accent, or maybe you know a couple different languages and it's this skill that is so attractive and appealing. In fact, you might attract a partner who is an elegant and delightful communicator. Someone who knows exactly what to say in order to get close to you, or vice versa. Or perhaps you attract someone who is quite literally a writer, or an artist, or a musician. Again though, maybe it's you who earns a living through such positions, Venus in the third house individuals, and so your partner is attracted to these things about you. Also, when in a relationship, you might do all you can in order to create peace and harmony with your significant other. You might wish to compromise and find a common ground with your partner, or you might seek to meet them halfway in situations, and you do this through communication. And so whatever disagreements arise, you tend to think about what you can both achieve as a couple, as a team. Now again, this is where the sign and aspects matter, because, well, for some of you, perhaps such things, they don't come all that easy. Maybe you don't even listen all that well. Or quite possibly your partner is super stubborn and they're stuck in their ways, resulting in a lack of intellectual understanding between the two of you. Still, however, I think you ultimately desire a fair and balanced intellectual outcome within your one-on-one relationships. Now, furthermore, I think you crave curiosity within your one-on-one relationships. So this idea of your partner keeping things fresh and new and interesting. In fact, you might even bring many new and exciting ideas into the relationship, all as a way to switch things up. That way your mind is stimulated, and so you feel a stronger, more closer bond with your partner. Not to mention, it's the same curiosity and intrigue that can enhance security and pleasure between you and your significant other. And it can also enhance sensuality and physical closeness. However, when it comes to envy and jealousy, well, these emotions may come out through communication. They may come out more directly or in a more subtle way. I guess it depends again on the sign that Venus is in. But when you feel any envy or jealousy come over you within your one-on-one relationships, maybe you think about it, or you verbally share it with your partner, or maybe you write about it in your journal or through song, kind of like Taylor Swift, who has Venus in the third house. And seeing as the third house also rules over siblings and our peers, well, it could be suggested that you experience jealousy and rivalry from these individuals within your life. So for example, maybe you would feel envious towards your brother's good grades when you were younger. Or maybe you experienced classmates who were envious towards you due to how well you did on your exams. Or maybe you find yourself becoming jealous towards your friends during times when they get praise for an idea or for a saying that you actually came up with. Also, there's a potentiality of you experiencing jealousy from your siblings towards your romantic lives, towards your romantic relationships. Maybe in their mind, they think you are so happy and you're loved up as if you have the most perfect relationship. But little do they know, you also go through difficulty as well. You go through difficult times. You go through times that just, you know, as we all get within relationships, times when there's disagreements, there's arguments, times when things are not the most pleasant. Still, however, perhaps you experience a certain bitterness or a saltiness from your siblings, or possibly even from your cousins or from your peers, from your classmates. And you know what? Well, there's a suggestion here of these people wishing that they could speak as well as you. or they wish they could get their point across as well as you. Then again, maybe it's you, Venus, in the third house individuals who can feel this type of way towards others. And so you will work on your communicative skills, etc. In fact, growing up, perhaps there were those of you who were popular, okay? You were pretty well liked by your peer group, in which case you had a few jealous and envious people, and they presented jealousy and envy towards you for being popular. Or maybe there were those of you who wanted to be liked by others, and you wanted to be friends with more people, but you weren't and you couldn't due to insecurities or due to a lack of social grace or a lack of elegance. As I've been saying, this is also why the sign and aspects matter. But ultimately, it's these relationships that meant a great deal to you, Venus, in the third house individuals. Whether they impacted you in a negative way or in a positive way. Though on the other hand, you know what? It could even be that some of you were bullied or you were made to feel less than by your peers or by your siblings. Though on the other hand, maybe you were enjoyed and you were appreciated by these people growing up. Perhaps some of you felt security and stability during your early schooling years, whilst others of you felt a lack of security and stability. Maybe some of you felt calm and comfortable, whilst others of you felt anxious and fearful. Though, to be fair, it may not have been as black and white as this, and perhaps things were much more complex. Now, another thing I want to mention about the relationship side of things is to do with short trips and exploring around your local city/area. See, I also think you enjoy that exploration with your partner when in a relationship. So perhaps you enjoy quick trips to a coffee shop or to your local park. You enjoy visiting different restaurants or activity centers. Basically, you like to be on the move. You like to be out and about with your partner. Oh, and you may also enjoy intellectually challenging conversations. Conversations that hold your focus, they hold your attention, especially given that you can become easily distracted by your outside environment. Again, though, the sign and aspects, they matter here, so just keep that in mind. But when your partner can hold your focus, when they can mentally stimulate you, it's a pretty good thing, Venus in the third house individuals. I also think there's those of you, or there's times when you enjoy general chit-chats and conversations with others. These conversations that don't have to be too heavy or serious or too personal even. They're the types of conversations that include how somebody else's day is going, for example. But yeah, you might find such chats to be enjoyable. In fact, you might be known as the super friendly and social neighbor, or you might be known as the sweet and kind customer at your local coffee shop. Therefore, there's a type of beauty that you bring to your local environment, and there's a type of beauty that you bring to any conversation you're involved with. So the last thing that I want to mention is how people may actually go to you for relationship advice. Because not only do you possess some pretty sound and beneficial pieces of advice and knowledge, but you also won't force your ideas and your opinions onto others either. Plus, you won't come across as judgmental or as somebody who's going to ridicule other people. You'll seek to listen, you will seek to hear the other person out truly, and when you deliver your perspective, you will also most likely be conscious of the other person who may be on the receiving end. though ultimately Venus in the third house individuals, it is you who has such a gift, you have such a talent when it comes to communicating with others. Okay then, Cosmic Warriors, so that concludes my video all about the beauty, relationships, envy, and seduction of those of you who have Venus in the third house within your natal birth chart. Now, if you do happen to have Venus in the third house, then please let us know what you thought of the video in the comment section down below. It would be great to get your feedback. But with all that being said, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. And of course, if you would like to see more videos from myself and you have not yet subscribed, then make sure that you click that subscribe button. And also make sure that you give this video a like, remember. And I will be back with another video very, very soon. Bye.